Hey guys, so welcome back. So today we are going to start our lecture number 2. So in this lecture we'll try to understand that what kind of subscription or license we need to use this Microsoft Intune or Microsoft Endpoint Manager services. Okay, so there are bunch of license which we can use, and all these license are comes in a package, or few license are a individual license. So we'll take a look one by one. So the first one is a Microsoft 365 E5 or E3. So once we see that E3 or E5, that means these license belongs to enterprise only. If we talk about like a enterprise mobility plus security, this is the package and it also belongs to enterprise. There is another license type which is a Microsoft 365 business premium, is for small business. F1 or F3 for research, I think, I'm not pretty much sure, but you can take a look in the Microsoft portal. This G5 or G3 belongs to government department. And for education purpose, there are A5 or A3. So if you want to take a brief look about these license types, you can go to this URL. I'll try to paste this in video's description. So let's try to take a look. So if we talk about the license, this is the URL, and as I said, for education, government, non-profit, and frontline workers, and Microsoft 365 for enterprise. So if we'll click on education, so see, here is the for student, they have a different package. If you are a student, you can try this. A1 is a free, no commitment. Okay, so you can get all these apps if you are using these license as a student. You need to provide your identity that you are a student and you belongs to this university or college, and after that you can get a license. There is a A3 or A5 for the student. For teachers and faculty staffs, there are a A1, A3, A5, but they have a slightly changes in price. Okay, so if we'll go back, for government purpose, I don't think they will allow us to view this license, but we'll try to see the non-profit mean kind of, I think, NGO. So information not available. Frontline workers, they have a F1 for frontline workers. So F for stand for frontline workers. So there is a F1 and F3. So if you can buy these license, you can get PowerPoint, Word, Excel, OneNote, email calendar, Outlook, Exchange, Booking, all these things you can get. So if we can take a look about these Microsoft 365 for enterprise. Okay, so if we'll see that enterprise, we have a E3, that is a Microsoft 365, E5 and F3. If you can see that you can get these apps if you buy the license, and email, meeting, you can get a Microsoft team, a device and app management, Windows, you can manage a Windows device, safeguard, social and internet, files and content, you can store your file on OneDrive, Stream, Sway, List or Forms. Work management, you can use Planner, Power BI, all these things. Analytics, you can use these. Threat protection is there. Compliance management is there. So guys, this is all about the license. So now how we can check license on Microsoft Endpoint Manager. So you need to log on to this endpoint.microsoft.com. From here you need to click on tenant administration, tenant status. From here you can see that I have a 250 license and I have assigned 5 license to my end users as of now. So as there is a thing, if you have a Microsoft Azure, you can't use the same subscription for Microsoft Endpoint Manager because we need a different license for this Microsoft Endpoint Manager. So as you can see, I have a total 250 license which is showing on Microsoft Endpoint Manager Admin Center. If I'll go to my Microsoft Azure, so you need to log on to portal.azure.com, then click on Active Directory. Under license, from here you need to select this option from Manage License and All Product. So here you can see I have these E5 license 250, but as I said that Microsoft Azure required a different license for manage the device, that will help us for a conditional access policies, all these things. So those license called a premium license P1 or P2. So I have also Intune license. So mainly there are three type of license. One is a Intune, another one is a Enterprise Mobility Security, and third one is a Enterprise E5 E3. So guys, I hope you have a good understanding of license as of now. If you have any question, please go to Microsoft document and clear your doubt. And if you have another thing, you can comment in the comment box. So thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.